Hello, so today I am sharing a special project. So this is a customized market stall stand and it has been primed with white gesso. I want to create a Lindy's supermarket scene here because this is something that would exist in a dreamland. And so this particular caddy has been customized to fit in and hold these magical bottles as well as some embossing powders. So let's begin, and I'm going to be sharing my entire process of altering this particular market stall. To begin with, I'm using tilter wheel teal and just randomly spraying onto the entire surface and using a paintbrush to spread the color out. What this does is it gives me a nice light blue base coat for me to sort of begin altering this particular caddy. Next, to begin adding texture, I will be using this particular stamp and stamping with VersaMark and heat embossing it with a golden tone. And I'm going to be doing this on all the sides of the caddy except for the inside and storage spaces. This just gives me a nice golden first layer of texture to begin with. Here's a look at this beautiful shining texture that I have so far. Next, I want to create a colored texture paste. And for that, I'm using this sand texture paste, mixing it with a shaker and creating my colored texture paste that I can later use through a stencil to add further texture onto the sides of this caddy. So once my paste is ready, I'm randomly just spreading it through the stencil onto the surface to get this lovely texture. What I also did was I used the remaining texture paste that I had and just spread it onto the pages of my journal book through the same stencil instead of wasting it. Next is my most favorite technique. And for this, I'm going to be using two shades of magicals. One is a green tone and the other is a teal. And I'm just mixing them both with water onto my palette. And then I randomly begin splattering them onto the surface with the paintbrush. So I first go in with the blue color, splatter it and then mist it with water and heat set it. And once that's dry, I go in with the green tone. Again, same technique, splattering and misting it lightly with water. What this does is it gives me nice random blobs of color, and I can then see my multiple layers so far beautifully, and just adds this dual tone of different colors onto my surface. So I'm going to be using the same technique to color the entire surface of this caddy. Here's a look with all the beautiful color and shimmer so far. Now to bring in some contrast, I'm also going to go in with a magenta magnolia gold shaker in the same way, just splattering all over the surface and lightly misting it with water and quickly heat setting it. I also use the same color to sort of color the rims and the edges of this caddy to bring about that contrast. Next, I'm going to be using this wax and highlighting the texture that I created using the sand paste. So since it's grainy, it's just going to sort of highlight it and make it a little more prominent, adding a bit of this shine and shimmer. Now I here have some die cut elements that I'm going to be using for my layers and just embellishing this caddy. And to color it, I'm going to create a custom glitter paste. So here I'm just using some transparent glossy gel, mixing it with two shades of shakers and adding this white glitter to it. So with that, I'll have a colored glitter paste that I can then use to color my embellishments. To color the embellishments, I'm just using a palette knife and gently spreading this glitter paste that I've created onto the entire surface of this die cut element. And I ensure that I do this on a craft mat, because once I've covered the entire surface, I can just lift off the die cut and scrape the excess glitter paste from the mat and reuse it. Here's a look at the colored die cut elements. I also used Grab-A-Guy gold shaker to create this custom gold paste for some of the die cut elements. And I used the same glitter paste to also color a chipboard element that I thought I'd like to use for my layering. Here I also have another chipboard which says Dream. And I've just colored this with three shades of embossing powders, just going one color at a time and randomly spreading to create this multi-tone effect on this particular chipboard element. Now it's just the time to layer and create a beautiful composition, adding all these lovely embellishments onto this particular caddy. I also want to add some flowers, but I need colors that would match my entire color story here. So I just spray them with a bachelor button blue and later with witch's potion purple so that it matches my color scheme. I've also used a feather embellishment here, which I've heat embossed with the same gold that I used on my background. Now that's a look at all the layers and the embellishments so far. I added some art stones, and how I colored them was the same way that I created my glitter paste. So I just added some glossy gel. I added a copper shaker to it, mixed my art stones in the paste and added a little bit of the glitter and just randomly spread them here and there on my base. So that's another easy way to color art stones. So that's a look at the caddy so far, with all the beautiful layers, the elements, the embellishments, and I really think it makes for a nice dreamy market stall for the most favorite brand, Lindy's. And here I just wanted to show you how I used the remaining glitter paste through a stencil, just added it onto my journal page, and also leftover magicals or shaker colors that I had, splattered them. So that just makes for a cool funky background. So nothing really is wasted when using that. Now to complete my market scene, I've also in the same way created this nice delivery bicycle, colored in the same exact manner as I did for the caddy, just adding splatters of colors everywhere and embellishing it with some heat set chipboard elements, some flowers that have been custom colored using Lindy sprays. So that's just going to complete my market scene that I have pictured in my mind. To complement this particular caddy. So I really hope you've enjoyed the tutorial, and I'm just going to be adding pictures of the entire scene as well as details of the different objects that I've altered today. Until the next time, take care and bye-bye.